The question we're trying to answer today is if you want to buy a new base, but you basically don't want to spend any money at all, how bad will it be? Let's find out. This is Gregor from Baseball.com, and over the last years I have reviewed a good bunch of Harley Benton basses already on his channel. And in case you don't know, Harley Benton is the house brand of Musikhaus Thomann, which is the biggest music instrument retailer in the world, located here in Germany. And what all these basses had in common is that they were all very affordable, which is of course always kind of the thing with these house brands, but they all were also surprisingly good, I have to say. None of them was truly terrible, but I guess here's another chance to mess it up, because this one is super affordable. This is the PB20. It costs only 89 euros, which is the most affordable long scale bass on their website. And yeah, this is actually less than a third of the value of the pickups in my main bass, so let's check it out. The design of the PB20 is obviously very close to the Fender Precision Bass, which is the most iconic bass guitar that has ever been built. It was designed in this way in the late 50s and hasn't much changed since then, and because the recipe just worked out, this is what people loved and still do. And it has kind of a warm, upright, bassish sound, and it plays very nice, and yeah, that's what people still stick with. And another thing that's very special about this bass, or any Fender design from back in these days, is that they were all designed to be built very easy and very cheap. I guess that's still a working recipe for a very low budget bass today, like this one. The body of the PB20 is made from poplar, which is a very popular substitute wood for the alder that you would usually find in such a bass. The neck is of course bolt on. It's made from maple, and the fingerboard, which looks like rosewood, is actually made from a wood that Harley Benton calls rose sacker or something like this, which is actually just maple, which went through a thermo treatment. This treatment makes gives the wood this dark color and also makes it very stiff. And there's nothing bad about this at all. I think maple fingerboards are very common, and so this is just a very usual sound. But because it looks like rosewood, it's a little bit irritating, because rosewood fingerboards often give this a very warm and mellow tone, which this one doesn't. But again, this is not a bad thing, just a little bit unusual. The neck has all the classical specifications that you would expect from this kind of bass. We have a 34-inch scale, we have a round C profile, which feels actually very nice, we have 20 frets, we have a 42mm width at the nut, and the only thing that I have to criticize here is that the frets are sticking a little bit out at the side, which doesn't feel very nice. It's not bad, it's not like you will not hurt yourself or anything, but yeah, I guess that's something that you have to fix afterwards, or bring this bass quickly to a guitar builder and get it done in a couple of minutes. It's not a big deal, but on the other hand, this is something that Harley Benton could also fix on their own before they ship out the basses. The tuners and the bridges seem actually very solid. It's of course not like the best quality, there's nothing to expect in this price range, but it seems solid. But only if you want to play this bass, if you're planning to play this for 20, 30, whatever years, then at some point you might want to buy some new tuners, because they will break at some point. That's always the case with these very affordable basses. But all in all, I have to say, craftsmanship of this bass is actually very, very okay. It's not getting much okayer for this kind of money, and I think It's actually much better than what I expected, I have to say. The pickups are, of course, this usual split coil set, which sounds great and very classical and normal, like P-bass. We have a master volume control, and this is the so-called tone control. If you use this and you dial it back a little bit, your tone becomes warmer and more mellow, and yeah, just listen for yourself. So is it worth to spend so little money on a bass, or is it just wasted because after a couple of months you have to go to the next music store and buy a better bass because your high expectations or needs or whatever? I guess that's up to you. Everyone might be a little bit different, but I can only speak for myself. I'm very surprised how good this bass actually sounds and is made. I don't have any expectations for an instrument that costs 89 euros because it can't be good at all, and it was beaten 1,000 times by this bass. René and myself were actually very surprised how well what kind of sound we were able to record with it, because yeah, again, we didn't have any expectations, and I kind of like the sound samples a lot, to be honest. So if you just want to buy a bass for some home recording, some occasional or whatever, go for it. You will be happy. If your kid wants to start to play bass but you don't want to spend so much money because you don't know if your kid will stick to it and you don't like it anyway, just kidding, buy this bass, you will be fine. And yeah, of course, there's the thing with the frets sticking out, which is not so nice. But yeah, as I said, this can be fixed very easily. And to be honest, I had basses here for like 2, 3, sometimes 4 grand that had exactly the same issue. It's never nice. And yeah, it doesn't matter how much the bass is. This should never happen. But yeah, when it's done once, when it's fixed once, this will never come back. And so don't worry about it. Yeah, I think it's a cool bass. If my kids wouldn't have instruments already, I would buy one of those. I wouldn't hesitate. I think it's good enough, definitely. It sounds cool. And yeah, I guess that's it. If you want to find out more about this bass, there's a link in the video description that brings you to the Thomann website. There are more specifications, there are more sound samples, and this is also called an affiliate link. So if you want to buy something like this bass or any other thing from the Thomann website, we as the bassdevil.com channel get a little bit of a kickback. So if you like these videos and want to support us, this is one of the easiest way. It doesn't cost you any money, just use the link, and your help is always very appreciated, of course. That's it for today. Have a wonderful week and month and life, whatever you're planning to do with it. See you next time. Bye bye. Thank you.